I went to that reunion social on Friday night. I couldn't stay away from it, but I have never seen so many former Florida State football, but Mickey Andrews was there, so many former Florida State football players and assistant coaches in one place at one time in my life. It was just, I mean, I was in heaven. I mean, we're talking, I started with Willie Jones talking about sacks and this and that. Jerry Thomas came back. I said, Jerry, you know, kick the field. Said, no, we win a champ. But anyway, it was just great. And Coach, you had a lot to do with that. You had a lot to do with bringing those players back to Florida State.
Yeah, and it was really important to me because, again, from afar, I always thought that's what Florida State was, you know, and a lot of those players I grew up watching, and the big reason why I fell in love with it, and watching Coach Bowden, Coach Andrews, and those guys coach here, again, that's what I can think about when I think about Florida State. And when I came back, I just didn't sense that when I got here. And then when I went to the bowl game, I was walking in the hallway with Deion Sanders. And we were walking by some of our players, and they were like, "What's up, Coach?" And I'm like, "Did you not see Deion walking next to me?" You know? That said something to me then that our guys, I just didn't feel like our players really understood the history and the tradition, and I wouldn't say necessarily respect the players, but understand those guys that helped build our program and a big reason why they wanted to attend Florida State. So after that bowl game, I went back and I talked to our player development coach and told him one thing I want to do for spring ball, I want to try to get back as many former players and coaches and make it a former players reunion and want that to be an annual thing that every spring football game we can honor our former players. Because they mean so much to our football program. And it's really important that they come around and be around our current players. I think it's important that they understand and get to know those guys as well.
Talk about your quarterbacks and how they fit into this golf course offense.
Well, all three of those guys are really talented. And all three of them have the athletic ability to be the quarterback for us and do the things we need for them to do in this offense. And Bailey and James, you know, they took the majority of the reps in spring ball, and they got better as spring ball went on. And now they have a better understanding of the offense. So this offseason, they can go out and take the receivers and get some things done. And DeAndre was able to do some 7-on-7 and did a great job when he was in there. He's still recovering from his knee. But I was really impressed, and it's the first time where I can say to myself, man, we got three quarterbacks that can go in and play. It makes you feel good, you know. But like I told those guys, they're going to have to separate themselves to show who's going to be the quarterback for us. And what I'm looking for, not necessarily who can throw the ball here and there, because all of them can do that. I want a guy that can lead this football team, a guy that can get his football player, his teammates to play for them. And I think we all can attest to it. When we had great quarterbacks that can do that, we won a lot of ball games. We won championships around here. So that's what we're looking for. And these guys have this whole offseason to get around their teammates and get to know them a little better and hold them accountable and let them know that they're the guy for the football team and that they're going to be able to be that leader.
For the first time since 2009, Bobby Bowden came to a Florida State football practice. And folks, I'm here to tell you, it was not by accident. You built a relationship with Bobby Bowden when you got the head job, Coach. And tell us about how you developed that relationship and how you got Bobby to come back to FSU.
Well, I remember giving Coach Bowden a call, and man, I was impressed with his energy on the phone and how upbeat he was. And I just told him I wanted to get over to come see him one day, you know. And at that time, he was traveling and going to do speaking things, and I was recruiting. So once recruiting got over with, found time to go over and visit him at home. And myself, Coach Odell Hagan, and Greg Fry, we all went over there, and I was sweating bullets going in there. I mean, this is, you know, I'm like a kid in the candy store. I'm getting ready to meet Coach Bowden, and opened the door, and he was there. He was smiling, and he welcomed us in, and we sat down and just listening to those guys talk about certain practices and games. And I was able to relate a little bit to games because I remember those games that they were playing in. But to hear what was going on in the locker room and on the field was pretty cool. And then for Coach Bowden, you know, to hear him talk about how he wasn't – He hadn't been out to practice for since he had left, and that was shocking to me, you know, personally. And he told me why, that he didn't want to the old coach to think that he was looking over his shoulder. And I said, well, coach, I want you looking over my shoulder. So, and I told him, again, I want him, I mean, give his opinion. I mean, there's no egos here. You know, I like your opinion. You come out, you see something. But more importantly, I wanted him to know that he was always welcome to our practice. This is a program that he built, and he should be allowed to go anywhere he pleased to go and come out to any practice he want to. He don't have to call me. Just show up or call our assistant to make sure his parking spot is open, and we have a golf cart there to get him, you know. And the same thing with Coach Andrews, who I saw earlier. I know he's here today.
Mickey's right in the very back. Chris, you got another question for Coach.
Will DeAndre Francois be ready for this year?
Yeah, he'll be back. He's competing with the other three for the job. And come training camp, he should be ready to go full bore.
Yeah, Mr. Taggart, can you talk about our running backs, the depth that we have? Just Ooh-wee. Give us a little knowledge.
Yes.
Oh, I see you grinning, Coach. I see you grinning, huh?
Yeah, we have some horses back there, some thoroughbreds, no ponies. That's probably one of our deepest positions on the football team, and you'll see a lot of times this season where at least three of them will be in the game at times. You know, we was talking earlier about your best players. Some of our best players are at running back. So, and one thing I hate as a head coach to be on the sideline and look next to me and one of our better players standing on the sideline with me, and it's like, that don't make a lot of sense. I need this guy here on the field. So, but we have a staple of running backs, and all those guys are very competitive, and they're helping each other get better. And I'm excited because of what they're capable of doing. And I know some of you got a glance at Kalen LeBron, what he can do. And he was doing that all spring. And he's another kid from day one when I met him. He wanted to give up his red shirt just to play in the bowl game. Like, you don't want to do that, buddy, you know. But he's one of those kids, just he loves playing the game, and he wanted to be out there. And but he's doing a good job, and along with Patrick and Cam Akers and even Secondary, you know, we're pretty deep back there. So I'm really excited about that, and Rasul too, you know. So, man, I think this is the first time where I've had that many running backs and that you feel good about, and each one of those guys can go anywhere else in this country and start for a team.
Hey, Coach, what can we do to get that number 9 jersey retired opening game versus Virginia Tech?
Be there. You will see it. Just be there, and you will see that.
That number
Peter
9.
Peter Warrick.
Yeah, Peter Warrick wore number 9.
Hey, Coach, my name is Harrison Stange. I just want to ask a question. How do you think our offensive line will be next season?
I think our offensive line is going to be the foundation of what we do, and I call them the tunnel workers. You know, they're the ones that get it done and don't get noticed, and they'll be a lot better. You know, we had some guys out this spring, but it allowed us to play a lot of young guys and get them better, and which will help us when it comes to depth in the fall. But I think it'll be a lot better for us. It's going to be. If we're going to score points, they got to block, and not just block. They got to move people. You know, and do it the right way, and I think they'll be a lot stronger. And when we say lethal simplicity, a big part of that has been simple for our offensive line and allow them to come off the ball and rattle the feelings in the defensive lineman's mouth. You know, so we're looking for those kind of guys, and again, I think it'll be big time for us.